Tonight I'm doing a fundraiser for melanoma awareness, and I am just so proud to be a part of this event.
Hi, how are you? Thank you, hi.
Earlier this year, I had my own scare with melanoma. I want to thank you all for coming and supporting the melanoma awareness cause. And it has just made me even more passionate about this cause.
I get that the only thing that will fulfill your soul again is to give you your loved one back. That is something that nobody can do. But I will validate that they are still with you, okay? So, who passed in the tragedy? What was named after someone? Who's that? It has to be a park or a baseball field.
My daughter's playground.
And it was named after her, is that correct? In memory of her?
My name's Lisa, I'm from Huntington, and I'm here tonight with hopes to connect with my daughter, Victoria. I am hoping to hear that she's always with me.
I was shown something about a pillow.
I sleep with her pillow.
Do you connect with ladybugs?
The ladybugs visited me in the winter.
Perfect. That is her sign and symbol that her soul is with you at that exact moment and that she's okay.
I got ladybugs 3 times throughout the winter, so I was just blown away by that.
She told me that she passed sudden and unexpected, but then she looked at me and said, I lived a life and it was my life. And I lived a full life and I always felt special and loved.
She was a full of life child. She did gymnastics. She loved her friends. She passed 2 days before her 8th birthday. I had never thought in my life that I would feel pain like this.
Was she your only daughter? Because she looked at me and she goes, Teresa, my mother feels as if she lost everything. Not only did she feel that she lost her only daughter, but her best friend.
Victoria passed when she was trapped in the cabin of a boat that capsized on July 4th, 2012. Me and the 2 children went with friends on their boat to watch the fireworks in Oyster Bay. I knew when we hit the water, she was below us. I was just screaming on the top of my lungs her name to see if someone had pulled her up. I said, this can't be happening. This cannot be happening. I was screaming my head off, crying, screaming into the night. It was just horrible.
She says, I want you to know that I might not have had a quantity of life, but I had a quality of life. She says, I would not have traded that for anything. Do you have the angels in the windows or something?
I have an angel statue that my brother gave me, and it's in my kitchen window, and I sit at the kitchen window.
That is her sign and symbol that her soul is with you at that exact moment and that she's okay. Know that the days you say, I don't want to get up in the morning, I don't want to do this, and then all of a sudden you just get up, know that that's your daughter kicking your butt out of bed.
She's the driving force that keeps me going. And this reading gives me just a teeny bit of peace that she's okay.
So, I want to talk about the young boy that departed with the hitting of the head. I don't know if he fell off a bike or was ejected.
That's my brother.
Okay.
My name is Stacy. My sister Teresa and I were here to connect tonight with my brother Frank.
He talks about the way that he was laid to rest. Because he keeps showing me the black headstone where I can see my reflection, which means that the headstone is very unique.
He has his emblem from Syria. He graduated from Culinary Institute of America. He had that put into the headstone.
So know that he supports on how he was laid to rest.
My brother was one of my best friends. I spent days on end with him. I worked with him in the same restaurant. I miss my brother every day.
Your brother says, I want you to stop saying, why were you there? Do you understand that?
I do.
Because he said, I take full responsibility for that. I read someone's soul, And what your brother told me is when I got really deep into the soul, I lifted a Band-Aid, raw wound. As if your brother died yesterday. Fair enough? And your brother said that for you, it's about releasing the negativity, the anger, because that's not going to bring him back. All it is doing is stopping you from being able to heal from his passing.
She's been very angry since my brother died, and I thought as time went on, she would heal, but it appears that after 23 years, she really hasn't.
Do you hear your brother call your name, or do you sometimes think you hear his voice?
Only once, at Christmas, one time when I was baking.
Know that that was him.
Yeah.
It wasn't your imagination, wasn't wishful thinking. Know that that was him letting you know that he was with you at that exact moment.
It certainly helps to close a door and give you a little bit more closure on something that has burdened us for so many years. More like burdened our hearts than anything else.
I want to talk about who's wearing someone's necklace. And who's that?
My mom.
Okay.
My name is Kim. I came with my sister, Lisa. And I came all the way from Georgia to connect with my mother. It's been 4 years since my mother passed away from lung cancer. And we all miss her very much.
Your mother also talks about a shawl or something, or like a mink stole.
She has mink coats.
She got more than one?
She had several, and they're still in my dad's closet.
Larry, we got an issue right now, big time. I got a bunny that we rescued, that's all I got. Anyway, she's like, tell them I have really nice feet. Because when they show me Fred Flintstone feet, and then they show me like perfect feet, like with red nail polish, it's my symbol for they don't have any more issues with their feet.
Her feet were not very nice, so, and I think she would be killing me that I said this, but I think that was definitely her way of showing that she's doing a lot better now.
Did you tell your mother it was okay to let go?
Oh my God.
Because she wants to thank you for releasing her soul. But she says, she told me to do that. She goes, and now she's mad that she told me to do that.
I miss her more than anything in the world. She was definitely the glue to our family, and it's sometimes empty without her, so.
Did you like kiss her eyes or do something with her eyes as well?
Yes, I closed her eyes.
So know that as you closed her eyes, her soul was with you.
Just hearing that she was there and she knew that I was there was amazing, and I was in shock. Those are some things that I had not told people.
Now who wasn't at her departure? I know this might be hard for you to hear, but she could not let go with you there. Do you understand that?
I couldn't be there.
She doesn't want you to feel bad or feeling that you were not there for her in her hour of need.
Lisa needed to hear Theresa tonight very badly, and I feel that she does have some relief from this.
So know that her soul is at peace and that nothing was left unsaid.
I will go back to Georgia knowing that my mom is always with me and is always around me and my family.
Your loved ones did an amazing job, and I want to thank you for coming this evening, and may God bless each and every one of you. Thank you.
I am very glad that I flew from Georgia to come and see Theresa tonight. This has been an amazing experience, one that I'll never forget.
Good luck to you. I wish you all the best.